Good morning. I've had a wonderful time with Verity and Alex. It's been amazing. We've learned so much. We've learned that even cars respond to reverse psychology. That was pretty cool. Video coming up of that. I've learned that Alex can look like he's conducting an orchestra, and Verity can multitask by dancing, singing, and playing a computer game. And I just stand there looking like an idiot trying to wave things around and bashing the ceiling. So some fun videos coming up on that. We've been sitting listening to my spiritualist reading this morning and reflecting on Andy saying about a wooded area. And one of the wooded areas that came up for me when I was with the medium, well, were two areas really. One was in Danbury and one was at Petwood Hotel here in near here in Woodall Spa. So I'm going to have a little walk around the woods later today in Woodall Spa and see if I can connect with Andy, but I will connect with Mother Nature if nothing else. I might even take my shoes and socks off, do a little bit of forest bathing, which is always good for the soul. Anyway, before I head off, we've still got lots more catching up to do, me and Verity, before I go, but I'll catch up with you later. Before I do go, she has this in her bathroom, all on board, all on the board. And there was one that really struck me, so I'm just going to read it to you. If you aim for perfection each and every time, you may be disappointed with how you do. It's perfectly all right to just be good enough. After all, you are perfect being you. There's your thought for today. Perfectly imperfect. Verity won't like that bit. She's just like, perfect being you is what she likes. We're not perfectly imperfect, we're just perfect. We're our kind of perfect, and that's okay. I know, Verity's just gifted me this book. Thank you.
Go! Yes, you're on camera now. Here we go now. We go home. I need a wee. Let's go home.
There's a beam up there. You're the eye of the tiger and she's punching the house.
God, it's knackering, isn't it?
Whack them. Yeah, yo. Nailed it.
Singing, dancing, and playing. I'm at the Admiral Rodney pub in Horncastle. I meet my lovely friend Kim, who I've known for 20 odd years, and just had a lovely, lovely lunch here. And I was just looking up when this pub was built, because it's quite nice. I thought it was Art Deco, but it's not. It's built in the 1950s. There used to be a pub called the Rodney here, but that was demolished and it was renamed Admiral Rodney after George Rodney, George Bridges Rodney, who was known to this area. who was an admiral and in 1780 beat the part of the Spanish fleet and 1782 part of the French fleet. So he shot to fame, and there's lots of pubs in England apparently called Admiral Rodney. So that's where we are. We've had a very nice life. Here at the Petwood Hotel, which was a favourite haunt of Andy and I, and also of the Dam Buster Squadron. Also, there was an officers' mess here. This is what this hotel is very, very famous for. The Dam Buster Squadron were all based here. Guy Gibson and his colleagues. We've had many a nice time here, and also just up the road from here, there's Jubilee Park. It's got an outside lido. It's also a caravan park, and there is opposite that Cinema in the Woods, which is a really old cinema that has the organ still coming out at times off the floor, off the ground. This is the officers' mess. It has been revamped in 1968, but this is where they'd used to meet, and I've just spoken to the hotel historian Edward, who was really lovely, and he's also the author of the third edition of the book, Petwood at War, I think is an extra chapter he's put in, so I'm gonna have a little perch for that. And he's here most days, so you can come and talk to him and he can give you the history of the room. And it did actually have two squadrons actually eventually amalgamated here. And I remember last time Andy and I were there, it was probably about a year or so ago, and a helicopter landed down here. It was really funny. We had fun sitting up on the patio trying to guess who was in the helicopter. We were completely wrong. It was these two young lads. We didn't get it right at all. But when he was in hospital as well, especially over Christmas, we're like, oh, you know, we spent so much time in that hospital room that we were going to treat ourselves to a hotel stay overnight here, because we never ever did stay overnight. But maybe I might just have to treat myself one day, just to remember him. So this is where we saw the helicopter take off, actually. I wonder if I've still got it on video. But do you know what, when the medium said to me about the woods, that he wanted me to come back to some woods, and I wasn't sure if it was the woods that I went to up on the mountainside, but this is what I thought of straight away, that there were some woods that he wanted me to come back to, have a eureka moment, a light bulb moment, and just walk through the woods and connect. There are quite a lot of woods here, but those woods over there, this is where we used to walk along this path and up through those woods. Oh, getting a bit breathless already, sorry. I'm breathing, and look, oh, as if by magic, love Mr. Ben, but there is a love heart. Into the entrance of these woods, giving me the biggest smile on my face. Do I go that way? Or do I go that way? I'm not sure. I'm just going to close my eyes and just go. On walking down that path there, and something pulled me back to this little bit, and it was just like, wow, Look, it's just like Christmas trees in the middle. And it's almost like a circle of trees, a bit like pagan-y really. I love it. And I've just realised that I have some of Andy's ashes with me. So, and I'm being pulled over there. Look at the foot of this tree. It's like a dinosaur's foot. And Arthur, our grandson, loves dinosaurs. And I've just pulled this tree from over there. That's crazy. I don't know what this tree is, but if anybody else does, please let me know. Because it's like it goes down. It's almost like divided pieces. It's like different trees joined to make one. Or actually to make one, two. But it's just the way it comes at the bottom, and it just reminds me of the twin flames. Of like being divided and coming together. That one's only just down there. If anyone knows, please let me know. Sat in that copse of trees for a while. I just bought Edward's book and a Petwood pen. And as I was walking back, I'm like, well, as I was sitting there, I was like, what's this eureka moment? What's this light bulb moment? What's it going to be? And it was like, I don't want to leave here just yet. And we talked about coming here. Why come back? You're here already. I'm off now to Tattersall Lake to stay with some very good friends. And I could probably stay with them again tomorrow night. But you know what? I've just booked in here to stay for tomorrow night. And oh, I feel so emotional, but it's wonderful. It's absolutely wonderful. And I could have got a garden room or a garden view room or another room. The normal room was 115 for a double or 145 for the garden, but I've told my story and they've got a room with a partial view, so she's going to do that, a partial view of the garden. So she's done me that for 115 bed and breakfast. I'm so happy. And now, just to finish my day off, make it complete, I'm going to go and see my third lot of friends over at Tattersall Lake. But I forgot to say, the main bit of the revelation was, Karina, you need a break. Stop running around the countryside, visiting. I know I've had a break at home, but it's nice. He's saying to me, just treat yourself. I know it's extravagant, but you deserve it. Just go with it. So, bye-bye for now. See you in the morning.